Right, Aki Kareem, BBTV. I'm joined by unbeaten prospect Louis Edmondson, who's just had a fresh beard trim.
I've been down the old Turks. Look, they got me looking good.
They got you looking fresh, mate. Well, you also look very good in your last fight. You know, it was on a big show, the Matchroom show. I tuned in early. You were fighting John Telford, someone who I know very well, got a lot of respect for him and his team. But, you know, you looked really, really good. Were you happy looking back at the performance? Were you happy with that?
Yeah, well, you know, obviously, before we took the fight, we knew it was going to be a bit of a step up in opponents to what I fought before. And we knew he's a tough competitor. But at the same time, we knew we could get in there and get the job done. And, yeah, I'm very pleased at how it went. I don't think I took a shot, and I think I got the job done in style.
One thing a lot of people looked at with you is you're quite big at the weight. You've got a big frame and everything. You're coming in good shape, but the speed was impressive. The speed, you popped off good combinations. So is that something that's going to characterise your style going forward?
Yeah, definitely. And I think a lot of people find it hard to work me out. They don't get long enough, and by the time they're trying to figure out it's over, you know. So, it's definitely going to confuse people, and the sharpness of my shots, I think people's going to struggle to deal with it, definitely.
Well, you proved that you're ready for the level up, and you've actually proved that you're probably ready for another step up in class. So it is the plan to move you along quite quickly?
Yeah, obviously I'll leave that to Billy Joe and TK, but I don't want to wait around forever, you know. And obviously, I think that last fight just proved it, that I don't need to wait around too long. So definitely, as and when the team think it's right, we're ready to move on.
And how did you find the bubble? Because I know you're a bit of a character, and I'm sure and Billy Joe. We all know what Billy Joe's like. So you two together in the bubble. I mean, I did see some of the build up stuff, but what was that like for you? And did you enjoy that side of things as well?
You know, it was a good week. It was unbelievable. Obviously, everyone's on top of each other. Obviously, you know, it is a fight week. It's making the weight, and that it's a little bit like that sometimes. But we had a good laugh, and the whole team there were laughing and joking, and it's good vibes. Everyone's good to be around, and it was a great week.
Now the fight was at super middleweight, but you know you're quite tall as well, and you know there. There are some people that was commenting on social media saying he could do like heavyweight as well or whatever. But are you finding that the super middleweight's a good weight for you, or is there any give?
Super middleweight is my weight through and through. Obviously, I've had a few fights, a few early fights at light heavyweight, but I'm a super middleweight. I don't struggle to make the weight. I say not struggle. Obviously, it's got to be made, but at the same time, I'm eating well, I'm drinking well, I'm getting in there strong. So, yeah, super middleweight is definitely my weight. But who knows if this right opportunity comes at light heavyweight, then we'll take that with both hands as well. I think I'm strong enough to compete at both weights. So, yeah, we'll just see what opportunities arise and go from there, definitely.
Now, last time I spoke to you, you was getting introduced to the gypsy style life. You were starting to live in trailers. You were starting to do all of that. Now, I believe you're living on Billy Joe Saunders' land. You've gone full honorary gypsy style. Tell me about this, mate. How did this sort of even come about?
Well, between Dennis McCann, Tom Little and Billy Joe, I don't think I've had much choice, have I? So, it's been one of them. But, obviously, I'm in a mobile home now with...
Show us, mate. Yeah, show us.
I'll turn this camera around. Let's have a look. So this is me.
Yeah.
Let's have a little mooch. There's Billy Joe down there. Can you see him? You can just see him getting out the car. But So obviously I just made the move to stay up here with Bill. So we can train alongside each other all the time. It's just me and him on the land. We're training all the time, grafting, and I'm learning loads just being around him every day. You know, it's not just the boxing side of it, the mental side of things. And I feel like mentally I couldn't be in a better place. And physically I'm in the best shape of my life as well. And it's just, yeah, it's just unbelievable, you know.
I mean, he's such a talented fighter. And also, you know, he's one of those sort of fighters where if the opponent in front of him's level's raised, he raises his level dramatically. You know, sort of things are you learning from him? On that, you mentioned the mental side. We know about the boxing side, a class from both of you. What sort of tips is he giving? Don't give us the secrets, but what sort of tips are you developing from the mental side of the game?
It's just like, just little things. As you said, you don't want to give too much away, but it's just little things, even down to our runs, down to sparring, down to how to act in certain situations and how to act a certain way to get other people to react a certain way, you know? It's just, he's a very, very clever man, that's for sure, isn't he?
Oh, definitely, definitely. And he's a businessman as well, and he's got a lot of things. I mean, one thing I like about Billy Joe is he's also a businessman, and you know, if boxing stopped tomorrow, he'd still be fine. And that's a really important thing, I think, for young fighters. You're only 25 years old. You know, is that something that you're interested in as well, developing a future as well and making sure everything's cool, investing the money, things like that?
Yeah, definitely. I think, as you said, it's very important for fighters, excuse me, to invest the money properly, because this it's not always the great career with millions of pounds that everyone expects, is it? And so I think it's definitely it's a big thing for us to invest our money properly. And as you said yourself, I don't think there's no one better to have by my side to guide me in the right direction, as he is already doing so.
And on the boxing level, that's a sort of training and sparring and whatever that, you know, your money cannot buy, really. You know, day in, day out with Billy Joe and all the people that are associated with him, he can pull a lot of strings for you as well. Is that brought on your game a hell of a lot then in terms of your own technique?
100%. I feel like since I've been around him, I feel like I'm improving every single day. And the improvements are not small. They're major improvements, you know. Just down to how to manage in the rounds, and I'm doing 8-10 round sparring now, no problem. Just clicking my fingers, you know. It's just great all round, and that's all I can say, really.
Well, your last fight was a scheduled 6-rounder, wasn't it? Yeah, 6-rounder. Are you going to be moving up to 8-rounders next, or are you looking to have another couple of 6-rounders? What's the score with that?
Obviously, I'll leave that down to Bill to decide, but I'd like to move on now. I'd like to do 8 rounds, really. I know, obviously, it was scheduled for 6, but it's not just about the fights. It's what you're doing in the gym, and we know what I've got in the tank, so not too sure that the fights are going to be lasting too long once people start opening up, but I'd like to get scheduled for 8. And hopefully move on to 10 towards the end of the year.
Hey, that's fighting talk. I like a bit of fighting talk. But, you know, to be fair, you're backing it up. You're backing it up. You're only, 4 fights in now? And, you know, for your skill level, I mean, I think people were really impressed with that. Only 4 fights in. But you've had a lot of experience in the past.
Yeah, definitely. And I've had a decent amateur career, and I've been around a lot of decent people. But I think, no disrespect, when I boxed a couple of journeymen, people haven't really seen what I can do, because it's hard to fight with someone that doesn't want to fight, you know. So I don't think no one's really seen the best of me yet, and I still don't think they have yet, even in that last performance. But I think we saw, obviously, when someone comes to fight, we're going to start to see the best of Louis Edmondson, and that's that.
What would you say is your best tool, like your best tool in your repertoire?
I'd say not taking too many. I don't take many shots at all, to be honest. I don't want to stand there headbutt and fist and see who can hit each other the hardest and see who can stand there the longest, you know. I'm about not taking those shots, catching them clean, and getting an easy night's work done.
You're also good at predicting fights, because you told me that you told me a while ago Joe Joyce was definitely going to beat Daniel Dubois.
Yeah,
John Hedges, Johnny Fisher. You were all dead confident of it, and You know, how did you see that? Is that just from being around boxing and seeing the inside and see and working with all these guys?
Do you know what it is? I just thought that Joe's that bit older, a bit more mature. And obviously, credit to Daniel. He's a great fighter. He's unbelievable. He's younger than me. And look at the things he's done in the sport. It's amazing already. But I just thought that Joe was a bit too mature. And he's been in them harder fights, them harder tests that for the past 10 years. And I thought it would be a little bit new to Daniel. And on that one, I got it right.
You know, people are talking about Canelo, how good Canelo was. I know you've probably already been asked a few times about this, and they're talking about Billy Joe with Canelo and everything. It's a fight we would love to see as British boxing fans. Nothing would be better than to see Billy get that opportunity. Now, obviously, people after the Canelo performance are saying things like Canelo's going to walk through Billy Joe, this and that. You know, you see him day in, day out. You can give us the picture better than anyone else. What makes you confident that Billy Joe could beat Canelo?
I just think he's all wrong for Canelo personally. I think he's obviously Canelo's an unbelievable fighter, and it's a task for anybody, isn't it? But I think he definitely, as he said himself, he's got all the tools in the box to beat him. I think his footwork will cause Canelo big problems. I think his hand speed and his reaction time. You know, it's like with the Callum Smith fight the other day. I felt like he was maybe with not having a rehydration clause, maybe he was a little bit too heavy and his feet was very slow. And if you stand there and you don't move with Canelo, you're in big problems.
Your style, it looked like your footwork was just, for your size and everything, really fast. So are you one of those sort of fighters who's going to be looking at being sharp rather than loading up and things like that?
Yeah, definitely, 100%. Just be sharp, not get hit in and out. I think footwork is a big thing. You see a lot of people, they turn professional and for some reason they just throw their footwork away. And I think you've worked all them years to get them feet how good they are in the amateurs, and then they turn professional and throw them away. I'll always keep my feet, and I think it's a good tool to have. It can get you out of danger. It can get you in the right positions. And yeah, definitely. And obviously credit to John. He's not a bad fighter, but I think on the night I turned it up and I didn't think he knew how to deal with it. I think once I switched southpaw as well, I think he said in an interview that he couldn't find much footage of me. And obviously there's no footage of me as a southpaw, so then I've switched southpaw and I see a change in his eyes. I saw it. As if to say, hang on a minute, do you know what I mean? What's going on here? And then it just started to go downhill from there. But again, credit to him. He's a decent fighter.
Yeah, credit. Because he's really tough, man. He's such a tough guy. You mentioned he's switching and everything like that. And that's, you know, it was impressive. I've seen some of your early footage and I've heard the crowd. I've heard your mates. I've heard the people you bring. They come with a lot of energy, man. But obviously, this was a behind closed doors thingy. That for someone like you with a massive crowd that comes down and everything like that, what was that like? But not just for you. What was it like for them who you know, always loved to come and see you fight and everything?
You know, they was all like getting together and they was getting it on big screens and stuff. And they had it all on big screens and outdoor screens. And so I think that they made a good event of it. I'm pretty sure the old beers were flowing and I'm pretty sure they was all shouting and screaming as normal, you know? So you got to make do with what you can do. But I'm definitely looking forward to crowds coming back. Hopefully it's not too much longer now. I know it's not looking good with all this tier four and all this going on, but hopefully we can get crowds back soon, man. We need it. We need them 500 Southampton supporters there going absolutely wild. And I'm sure they make a big impact on the TV for sure.
I've got no doubt about it. And the killer question, mate, when do you think we could see you out again? Because a lot of people are talking about when they can see you out again.
Yeah, I think, look, I'm ready to go now. I sparred yesterday, done 8 rounds yesterday. I could fight in 2-3 weeks if need be. But again, I think we're just going to enjoy Christmas, not have no stress over Christmas. Obviously, I've had a good win just before Christmas. I fought twice in December. So it's like, I think we're going to probably get out end of February, you know, enjoy the Christmas, have a little bit of food over Christmas, tick over, and then probably get back to camp and get serious and look at the options, you know, because we're definitely looking to push on this year, and maybe there's some names that we want.
All right, man, that sounds good. Are you going to tell us them names, or are you keeping them to yourself?
No, we can get it on. We want Zach Jelly. That's who right. we want. Zach yeah. Jelly. Let's get it on, brother, if you're watching. Let's get it on.
What a good fight that would be. He's just come off the, went off the Ultimate Boxer, the boxer yeah. competition. Thought he looked very good in that, explosive.
Yeah.
You and him. Whew, what a great yeah. fight. Fans, that would be.
I think, definitely. I think it'd be a good fight. I think I've got respect for him as a fighter. Obviously, he's game. He'll fight anyone. Strong, he's tough. But strong, tough and game, I don't think it's enough to beat me personally. I think I'll have him punching shadows. But we shall see. But I think that fight would definitely get a lot of interest. And as you said, I think it'd be a good one for the fans, definitely.
Yeah, definitely, definitely. Well, if he watches this, then he might have something to say about that and could get that one on.
Me and his dad's exchanged a few words already. So.
Oh, right. Yeah, he's a character, isn't he, his dad? He's a character.
Yeah, he's a character. If that's what we want to call it, yeah, he's a character.
Well, what are you doing over Christmas, mate? Are you going to stay a little bit active just in case a fight yeah. like that would happen in the early yeah. year, or are you like a family man where you're going to, you know, just unwind away from boxing, or are you going to be keeping an eye on everything?
It's I'm going back to Southampton today to see the family. I'm just literally about to do a run with Billy Joe in a minute. Go back to Southampton. Then what are we on now? Wednesday. So probably do a little something tomorrow. We have Christmas Day and Boxing Day just resting. And I'll be back up here the day after Boxing Day with Billy Joe and get ready again, you know. Obviously, Billy Joe's staying ready. He might have a Canelo fight. He might have the Andrade fight. So it's we're just staying ready, really, and I'm not overdoing it. Just staying at the right, what's the word? Right percentage and ready to kick into camp and get ready to go.
Brilliant, mate! Absolutely brilliant. Look, it's been really good catching up with you. Always. You I realised why I couldn't call you last time because you changed your number, didn't you?
Yeah. I'll tell you what it is. Do you know when you get them crazy women? The crazy ex-girlfriends that they won't leave you alone and they keep ringing the phone. So, you know, that's what it is. I had to change it because I'm just trying to
you're in demand, mate.
Career and I don't need no psychos on the case, you know?
Yeah, no one needs that, mate. No one needs that. I fully understand.
We just don't need it, do we? Don't need it.
Mate, you got to do what I did. Just get yourself married, get yourself settled down. But you're very young already, so you've got 10 years before.
Well, that's the plan. I'm 25 now, so that's it. I'm just ready to looking to find that right diamond, and then it's once I've found it, it's I've done enough looking now, so it's about time I found that right diamond and chilled out, you know. So yeah, we'll see what happens. Maybe next time we speak, we'll have a bit of news left. Maybe.
I hope so, mate. Listen, you do you, and whatever you do, just enjoy yourself. mate, it's been absolutely quality catching up with you. I really appreciate it. I'll get in contact with you again, like after Boxing Day or something, and we'll see how you're getting on, mate. And
have a catch
best wishes to Billy Joe as well. Tell him we said hello.
Yeah, I will do.
Enjoy your run, mate. Enjoy Christmas.
Thanks a lot. Thanks for your time. Hope you have a good Christmas, Aki. Good New Year. And we'll catch up definitely before soon.